Hey, welcome back to YT Finance, and this is the channel where I went to business school so you didn't need to, and today we are analyzing a plethora of articles surrounding the latest news updates, catalysts, and price targets for SoFi Technologies, Palantir Technologies, Nvidia, as well as Tesla stock. So for more videos on SoFi, Palantir, Nvidia, as well as Tesla, go ahead and annihilate that like button right now. Go ahead, press it right now because it helps me out so much. Subscribe to this channel for more news updates. And don't forget to become a member of this channel for as little as 99 cents because that's what keeps me here on YouTube. You can do this by pressing that join button right next to the subscribe button, and literally it's only 99 cents so you won't even feel it. So in today's stories, we will be analyzing an article titled, "It Seems SoFi Stock is About to Explode Higher." So this is phenomenal news for SoFi shareholders. Next, we'll be analyzing an article regarding SoFi's 2023 annual meeting for stockholders. So we will be going over a little bit of news which could come up in this overall meeting and how after this meeting it could cause investors to have even more confidence in this overall company, thus increasing their overall stock price. After that, we'll move on and talk about how Palantir Technologies has expanded their partnership with Jacobs, which is reflecting very positively on their overall stock price, acting as a good catalyst because Palantir is very good at not only bringing in customers but maintaining customers over the long term because their technology is just so good. Next up, we'll talk about how Nvidia touched $1 trillion for their overall market cap, what I think of the overall company, whether or not this artificial intelligence wave that is sweeping the stock market right now is good or bad, and whether or not investors should invest into Nvidia as of this moment. So we'll be going over their latest news catalyst and some fundamentals of that overall company. And then lastly, to round out the video, we'll talk about Tesla's TSLA shares and how Elon Musk recently returned from his China trip. So we already talked about the first day over in China, what Elon Musk did in the last video, but now we'll discuss what he did on his second day and whether or not this is good news or bad news for Tesla shareholders. So with that being said, again, don't forget to go and annihilate that like button for more videos on SoFi Technologies, Palantir Technologies, Nvidia, and Tesla stock. And without further ado, I say let's jump right into today's stories. SoFi Technologies, as you probably know, is a fintech company or a financial technology company that operates as a digital bank. And SoFi has shown significant strength, fundamental stability, as well as an amazing future growth trajectory regarding their share price. SoFi as a company continues to show impressive signs of strength and growth as time progresses, despite many of its peers collapsing. Many other fintech companies are completely going out of business and many major banks have failed recently, but SoFi still looks very strong. On top of that, as you're already aware, the FDIC insurance that they offer their depositors is essentially unrivaled, going up to $2 million as compared to other banks, which only offer $250,000 worth of FDIC insurance. So it's literally 8 times the overall national average. Now, the author of this article does, I think, get carried away because he compares SoFi stock to buying Amazon stock early on. And he equates this with saying that when investors bought Amazon stock, when the dot-com bubble popped, they could have turned $10,000 into $3.2 million. And he says it's the same for SoFi Technologies, for SoFi shareholders to have similar returns. Now, I do want to push back on this. I think this is overhyping this company. Amazon is a completely different animal than SoFi stock. Literally, SoFi would never be able to generate the revenues that Amazon can generate because Amazon is a part of a larger market and they are a market leader in those markets, such as e-commerce, cloud computing, and many other subcategories. However, SoFi Technologies is not, so I don't think it's actually a good comparison to say SoFi could surge as high as Amazon can, because according to their overall market and their strict competition, that's not a fair comparison. I personally really like SoFi Technologies. I've been reporting on them a lot. However, I'm very apprehensive about analysts or other financial reporters who are overhyping a company for their own benefit, so you do need to watch out for this. Although I do think SoFi Technologies is still a phenomenal company, I just would not compare them to a mega cap company like Amazon. Lastly, there was a debt ceiling deal which struck, and the great thing about this is that now the student loan moratorium will officially end in August. And this move is going to significantly benefit SoFi Technologies, or at least that's what's supposed to happen and that's what it's supposed to do. This just lines up perfectly because this could act as a phenomenal catalyst which will pave the way for the SoFi stock price to rally around 50% in the short term. So investors need to get ready for this. This allows huge upside potential for SoFi share investors. I'm sure this is going to be talked about in their upcoming 2023 annual shareholders meeting or their annual meeting of stockholders. That's going to take place on June 14th, 2023 on Wednesday. And to participate, you can either click the link in the description down below, because I always link my sources in the description so you can always make sure to do your own research to tell if this company is good for you. Right now, SoFi shares trade for around $6.98, while bearish analysts believe the company is only worth $2.50, which is absolutely ridiculous, while more bullish analysts believe the company could surge up to $10. For me personally, I only have a 4% allocation to this overall company, and I believe this company is going to achieve an $8 price target by the end of the year. And once it achieves that price target, the sky's the limit, because from then on, especially by the end of the year, the company is supposed to be profitable, which is going to act as another phenomenal catalyst, which will increase the price target well above $8 to $10. Therefore, analysts will have to reevaluate this company and increase their price targets. So it's going to be great news overall. Now let's talk about some more good news regarding Palantir Technologies extending their partnership with Jacobs. If you remember last year, we actually reported when this partnership happened. And Palantir Technologies, if you don't know, is a big data and analytics company, which also specializes in artificial intelligence in two main segments. One segment would be government agencies and government clients, while the other one would be commercial enterprises. And clearly Jacobs would fall under the commercial enterprises. Palantir did announce the expansion of their partnership with Jacobs, and Jacobs will now leverage Palantir's new artificial intelligence platforms to commercialize new artificial intelligence solutions, which will span critical infrastructure, advanced facilities, supply chain management, and many other things. The Jacobs CEO even commented by saying, "While we have understood the power and promise of artificial intelligence for years, we saw clear challenges with secure deployment. With Jacobs' continued focus on data solutions, combined with our deep domain knowledge, we are enabling AI to create value for our clients. Our expanded partnership with Palantir is a key differentiator in bringing built-in transparency, guardrails, and security solutions for our clients on a time horizon measured in weeks, not years," end quote. So overall, this is a very positive news update for Palantir Technologies, which has already surged more than 100% year to date in their overall share price, which is exactly what I said would happen back when the company was trading very cheaply. Jacobs is now incorporating Palantir's AIP platform to unlock speed, greater efficiency, and of course, it's going to help them make more informed decisions for their clients. The Palantir CTO, or Chief Technology Officer, also commented by saying, "Through the adoption of Foundry and now AIP, Jacobs is delivering end-to-end AI-powered solutions with real-time computing power, actionable data, and control. Our previous success in helping Jacobs' clients achieve efficiency improvements in energy utilization and chemical usage is only the beginning." So overall, a very powerful news update for Palantir Technologies, which is currently trading for almost $15, which is the high-end price target that this company could achieve over the next 12 months, meaning that this company could be considered overvalued to some. However, many bearish analysts believe this company is only worth $5 over the next few months. Clearly, the reason why the PLTR share price is increasing is due to artificial intelligence being the talk of the town and the buzz of the overall stock market. Many artificial intelligence players are being lifted in their overall share price because of the hype surrounding artificial intelligence, which would include Nvidia, which we will talk about right now. Nvidia touched a $1 trillion market cap as it rides this artificial intelligence wave as it sweeps over the market. Nvidia, ticker symbol NVDA, became the first chip maker to ever hit $1 trillion according to their market cap valuation, but since then it has dipped back below this overall threshold. Currently, the company is trading for around $400, while bearish analysts believe the company could fall to $222, and other analysts believe this company could reach or exceed $644 over the next year. The company currently has a market cap of $992 billion, making it one of the most valuable companies. Literally, it's only one of nine companies that have ever reached a $1 trillion market cap, joining the ranks of mega cap companies such as Microsoft, Google, Amazon, and Apple. Nvidia is surging for a multitude of reasons, but the main reason is due to their new high-powered supercomputer and a platform that will put generative AI to work in video game development. Nvidia shares have had a stunning year, up more than 165% since the start of 2023. Nvidia also is the center of the AI craze, thanks to their overall high-powered graphics cards and server products. An analyst even commented by saying, "It's something that they have earned," clearly talking about Nvidia here. What we've seen in their most recent earnings results is probably one of the biggest beats in the tech industry seen in probably over a decade, end quote. So a lot of hype is going over into Nvidia. The company says it expects revenue to reach $11 billion, plus or minus 2% for the second quarter, while Wall Street was looking more for a $7.2 billion revenue goal. And this is what's mainly causing the hype around NVDA stock. Just look at it. It has surged very dramatically over the past few months. Analysts are overwhelmed with bullishness and positivity for this company, with 49 of them saying to buy the company, 8 of them saying to hold the company, and 1 saying to sell the company, with an average price target of $439. However, despite this, I actually have to agree with Cathie Wood of ARK Invest, believing that this company will pull back in their overall share price once this artificial intelligence hype starts to decrease in the overall market. Since 2014, ARK Invest has believed that Nvidia saw the future of artificial intelligence or AI before most other chip companies, and now we believe it will continue to power the AI age. At 25 times expected revenue for this year, however, Nvidia, ticker symbol NVDA, is priced ahead of the curve, end quote. And that is a tweet coming from Cathie Wood of ARK Invest or ARK Investment Management, and I do have to agree with her on this. It seems that it's only a matter of time before Nvidia pulls back in their overall share price. Now, I don't know when that is going to be, and the share price in the short term most certainly could go higher. But please act smart, be prepared, and remember to take profits when you are green, covering your overall initial investment, because that is proper risk management. Lastly, let's talk about Tesla's TSLA stock and Elon Musk. Tesla is an electric vehicle maker that also specializes in energy storage as well as energy generation, as well as a plethora of other things. Elon Musk, who is the CEO, recently left Shanghai, wrapping up his two-day trip to China to meet senior Chinese government officials and other high-ranking personnel. Elon Musk, during his second day, visited the Giga Shanghai factory to produce his electric vehicles, and Musk praised his overall employees over there for overcoming difficulties and challenges, especially as the Chinese market continues to open up. So he is seen making many heart signs with his hands, and he really appreciates the work that is being done over in China. The country itself also values their relationship with Tesla because it brings in phenomenal technology. So Tesla as a business, as well as Elon Musk, was welcomed to increase their overall investment over into China and further expand their business. But it is interesting that Elon Musk himself has uncharacteristically, according to this article, remained silent about his overall trip and hasn't made any public statements. Little really is known about the conversations he had with government officials or Chinese government officials, which is quite interesting, but overall, I would say this was a phenomenal news update. Right now, the TSLA stock or Tesla shares currently trade for $203, while negative analysts believe the company should be worth $180, and positive analysts believe the company could surge to $280. For me personally, I think Tesla is easily worth $250 per share, so there's plenty of upside, and I am very bullish about the future of Tesla. We are also anticipated to receive more updates regarding Elon Musk's time over in China, which should also bring more positive catalysts to our attention, thus increasing the overall Tesla stock or TSLA stock price. With that being said, I would love to hear your thoughts down below on SoFi Technologies, Palantir Technologies, Nvidia, as well as Tesla. Don't forget to go and annihilate that like button. Become a member of this channel for as little as 99 cents so you won't even feel it, and it helps me out a ton. That's what keeps me here on YouTube. And for more videos like this one, remember to subscribe as well. With that being said, I will see you in the next YT video.